But you said that the FRBM has essentially become a statement of aspirational intent, which is true, right? I mean, year after year, reset after reset, we have chased that 3% target and, you know, sort of probably met it more in letter than in spirit in many years.
Right, absolutely. In fact, now that all observers and all advisors agree that the fiscal gate should be open, I think the time has now come for the government to pay back all past dues, declare, you know, start from a clean slate and declare that going forward, not more than 5 or 10 working days will elapse between the approval of a particular stretch of work on a highway or a particular purchase and the actual payment to the contractor. I think that will do a great deal to restore fiscal transparency and credibility within the system.
Okay. Ma'am, but how do we approach the next fiscal reset in the sense that is there going to be a rethink on whether that 3% target has become outdated given the way, you know, sort of global thinking has moved as well? Or is there still, I mean, if one looks at it from the broader perspective, we do still need to reduce our fiscal deficit. There's no doubt about that, our revenue deficit, et cetera. So is there a wider rethink that you think is likely or, you know, possible at this stage?
Yes, definitely. I think a wider rethink is necessary. 3% is a hook on which we hung our hats for a time. It was something we got from the Maastricht Treaty. There's nothing necessarily sacrosanct about it. So after the 2 years that we're now going to see where I'm recommending 6 monthly resets, after that, we will be in a good position to identify or quantify a very, very important parameter which governs fiscal consolidation. And that is the nominal rate of growth that we can confidently foresee. If you remember, the FRBM committee was going with a nominal growth rate of 11.5%. That unfortunately became a joke soon after because the economy was declining for 8 straight quarters before COVID already. But after 2 years, if we can see ourselves being able to project confidently a nominal growth rate, annual growth rate of 11.5%, let's say, going back to the FRBM, that then gives us a parameter on the basis of which we can specify our long-term debt to GDP target and map back from that to the fiscal deficit target, which will get us there in the long run. So the first thing that we have to do is to get real growth rate going without at the same time, you know, letting loose inflation. Inflation is already at the 7% mark, headline inflation. So we want to up our real growth rate while still keeping inflation under control, get to a point where we can say, all right, now we can see ourselves to having nominal growth at 11.5 or 11 or 12, whatever, at a certain point, we fix that. We fix that as not just aspirational, but achievable. And then going from there, we have that parameter in hand. We then look at the long-term debt GDP target that we think is good for us. And we map back from that onto the fiscal deficit, which will, in a steady state, deliver us to that eventual debt GDP target. I think that will be the way by which we have to think about it and move towards it.
The long-term debt GDP target, which had been put down by the previous committee, the FRBM review committee, was 60%. I mean, we'll close this year somewhere close to 85 or so.
Right.
So, you know, needless to say, that path to 60% may get elongated. But does that 60% also sort of need to be rethought given the global rethink that we're seeing, ma'am?
Very definitely. 60%, you know, it was justified by calculations which I challenged when I wrote about the committee report. I don't think we need to be that ambitious. I think 70% would do just as well. And with a high nominal growth rate, that wouldn't even require that punishing a fiscal deficit. Remember, at the end of the day, we are still a country with children who are being stunted and wasted for lack of nutrition. And that calls for revenue expenditure, not capital expenditure. Then we need capital expenditure. We are a country with unpaved roads, with bridges which are falling down, with buildings in Bombay which are collapsing. So there are a number of directions in which expenditure is not just desirable, but essential. We need not tie ourselves down with a 60% debt to GDP ratio, especially since that is not going to get us any enhanced virtue in the eyes of financial markets. It's just a number. We can choose 70%. We can choose 75% for that matter. as long as financial markets are convinced that the authorities who are driving this Indian economy have the economy well in hand, that they're watching inflation, they're watching real growth, they're responding to the need of the hour, and they have a nominal growth rate target that they think is feasible and achievable, and are mapping back from their debt target, which may be high at 75% to GDP, but then on the other hand, they're working systematically towards it. That's what financial markets want. They want steadiness. They want a steady hand at the controls of the economy.